Well, what about the price discovery thing we were talking about, Machine?
Oh, yeah. So look, Dexalot Discovery, I think a lot of people want to know more about this. So can you tell us what it is and how it works?
It is an innovation that maybe a blockchain environment, the DeFi, has been waiting for. And we are very happy to be working on this. It's very exciting because it's going to be, it's in a way, it's first kind, first of its kind, the way that we are delivering, obviously. At the token launch, there is no safe and transparent price discovery procedure currently in Avalanche ecosystem. The way it's happening, previous to Dexalot Discovery, people would open up a pool in AMMs. Bots will try to get in earlier than everybody else with sending the transactions over and over before if it's the contracts open. And they would get the available quantity before everybody else. And then when every everyday trader is piling on, they would sell whatever they got in the cheap side. They will sell it at a very high profit to people who are coming after them. So this is very non-transparent. It hurts the small traders. People don't understand why it's happening. There is an advantage to the technology, people who can write bots, right? So we're trying to solve all this problem saying, we're going to display everything before the market opens with a price. People can enter their, the sellers can enter their sell orders. The buyers can enter their buys, but we're not going to match them. So the order book is going to be like this in a way. It, you will see what is matching, but they're not going to match. So it's going to be dynamic. And people will keep changing their prices. And you can increase your price if you are getting in someone ahead, or you might say it is too expensive. I don't want to get in anymore because you're adding, in entering limit orders, and you know what you're getting into. You will not get a surprise price. You're not going to pay more than what you want, or you're not going to sell it less than what you want. That's for sure.
How pretty much every angle who participates in this process gets somehow hurt, other than the bot that got the assets at a very, very cheap price. I mean, the everyday user is getting hurt because they're getting essentially at a high price. The project gets a bad rep, and the platform that is providing this essentially gets affected as well. And I think we are going to see how Dexalot Discovery actually plays out in the real world. But the, so far, the tests are pretty promising. And if it solves the, this, addresses the, these shortcomings, it's a very, very promising innovation. Oh, one thing that we forgot to mention, actually, it's not good for the underlying platform either, in the sense like blockchain, because that bot activity and people piling up on a specific time to get, when time becomes important for them to do their trades, everybody piles up on that time, and that's a congestion point for the blockchain. So then the entire ecosystem actually suffering from that experience as well. So hopefully all these things come together. Dexalot Discovery will be a nice primitive to add to the ecosystem.
Also, one differentiating factor, the sellers will be able to deposit their tokens into Dexalot before they can claim it from their vesting contracts. So whatever, so that's the key. So before anybody can open up any pool, this process will happen, and we are guaranteeing it. Obviously, we can, we'll guarantee it for our own project, but any project that want to come in our in Dexalot to do the Dexalot Discovery, they have to work with us and implement that piece where there will be some time frame. They allow the deposit to Dexalot, but not fully claim, so anybody can open the pool.
Okay.
That's an important differentiation.
Yes, of course, of course. Very interesting. And you're going to have some sort of game about it, some sort of event. Could you inform the community about this? Because I think it's good. You guys are explaining it really clearly, but there's nothing like hands-on approach to really understand the beauty of things, right? Can you tell us everything you guys can about how to participate, the whole thing?
So we're actually doing three series of what we're calling the Dexalot Discovery Testnet Battle. It's actually a pretty simple concept, right? And the whole reason we're doing the battles is to allow people to play around with it, right? So we have all these mock tokens that we're airdropping to participants, and we'll open it up for say 24 hours. And people can start putting in their bids and offers. And at the end, we should be able to see prices matching. And then we close the auction, right? And come up with that one price. So the purpose of the battles, again, is for people to click around, to input trades, cancel trades, and re-enter the trades. Once you've done it once, it's pretty straightforward. Mm-hmm. And I think you'll see it.
We are dividing up the participants into two different groups. One group is sellers and one group buyers.
Okay.
The sellers are going to get one type of token and the buyers are getting one type of token. Okay. And then the sellers are actually incentivized how much money they make out of that assets they are selling. So the higher price they sell, the better their rewards are going to be. But on the other side, the buyers are being rewarded how cheaply they get, basically.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So therefore, it's truly a competition between sellers and buyers, and hopefully that will create a nice friendly environment to compete that somewhat simulates the real world.